Hey, welcome back to the channel. I'm John, and you're watching Road Reality. And today, we're gonna take a look at the Pan America and what I think is its closest competitor, the BMW R1250 GS.
All right, here we go.
Now, we don't know a lot about the Pan America, but I'm gonna go through some of the leaked information and the specs that I've found. And of course, we're gonna go through the BMW's specs. So we'll take care of that first. And then we're going to dive into how I think it is competitive, how I think it will be competitive, and what I think Harley has to do to make this one sell. So let's dive right in. Here we are on the Pan America website, and first thing we see is it's up in the air with that Knight Rider looking front end. But from a different angle that I found over here, it looks like a Road Glide, doesn't it? That shark nose. And then it's, of course, got the Bar and Shield logo back here on the gas tank. And we can see that Harley has already found a way to make hard luggage for it, which is pretty cool. I like that. But anyway, so specs, we know it's gonna be 1250cc V-twin, because of course it is. And it's expected to be liquid cooled, because of course it is. We've seen this before in the V-Rod, and it didn't do well. But beyond that, it's expected to have around 145 horses and 90 foot-pounds of torque. Now, I think Harley's underrating that. I think it's gonna be a little bit higher, closer to 160-ish, and right around 100 foot-pounds of torque. Other things we know, chain drive. Tried and true, pretty proven. Might be susceptible to rocks compared to what the BMW has, but we'll get to that in a minute too. And then there's price. Reportedly, it's going to start at $17,000, which would make it a value proposition. Go figure. Harley is known for making big, heavy, expensive cruisers. They might actually have one that that beats somebody else on price, and that's surprising. Beyond that, in this picture, you can see the knobby tires. Those are reportedly Michelin's, and Brembo brakes. Now, according to the production crew from The Long Way Up, with Charlie Borman and Ewan McGregor, those Brembo brakes are model specific to the Pan America and were adapted for the live wires that they rode. Hello, are we getting somewhere? The other big thing is gonna be suspension. It's unknown how much suspension travel this bike's gonna have, but it's gonna need quite a bit. We'll go through the BMW specs shortly. So it's got the look. It looks like it has a pretty low seat height compared to some of its rivals. And it's got the hard luggage I mentioned earlier. And look at this thing, it's in the air. Now, I don't know if they landed that jump, but we can only assume that they did. Well, something else we notice is skid plates. So I think Harley is actually taking this one seriously. And for a company that keeps losing money, they sort of have to. I mean, if this bike isn't a home run, that kills the Revolution Max engine in either the 1250 or the reported 975. Size that was supposed to be in the Bronx that is still shelved for some reason. I mean, Harley, come out with that bike already. I think it would actually sell. And if you bring the price down low enough, it would actually be competitive with some of its class rivals. I mean, yeah, build it. Something else we don't know is the size of the gas tank on this thing. But let's get into the BMW specs for a minute. The BMW R1250 GS, which is a proven adventure bike. We know that the BMW costs around $18,500 to start. This bike has ABS brakes, of course, and all the traction control and rider aids, and an adjustable windshield, all of which is expected to be on the Harley. And 7.5 inches of travel here in the front, 7.9 in the back. This seat height is pretty high at 33.5 inches, but you can get a factory lowered suspension that has a 31.5 inch seat height. Good for short guys like me, even though I'll still never flat foot this bike. This bike has a 5.2 gallon gas tank, and Harley's gonna have to beat that. And I know Harley can fit a lot of gas in a small space because the Street Glide tank, like the one on my bike, is 6 gallons, and it doesn't look it because that bike is narrower than some of its competitors. Go figure. The other thing is weight. This BMW weighs 549 pounds wet, so ready to ride with a full tank of gas. The Harley's gonna have to come in at closer to 500 pounds if it really wants to be competitive. I mean, it's already given up torque on the spec sheet, so you need a lower weight to make up for that, right? And I did mention that the Harley's gonna have a chain drive. This BMW has a sealed shaft drive, which I think is better for off-road use because less dirt and rocks are gonna get in there and chew things up. But Harley does have the parts and accessories catalog, and it's already this thick, so I expect it to grow to like that thick. Yeah, the power and weight of the parts and accessories catalog behind this bike really makes it easy. I mean, a potential buyer can just show up at a Harley dealer, ride the bike, and like it, just like you are this video. So go ahead and hit that subscribe button and leave this video a like if you're enjoying it. But yeah, that potential buyer can say, hey, let's flip through the parts and accessories catalog, and I want the hard luggage, and I want the tour pack, and I want extra skid plates. You know, you can buy all that stuff right out of the catalog, have the dealer install it, and on the road you go, or off-road in this case. Wouldn't that be nice? I think this bike has an actual chance because it's so far out of Harley's wheelhouse that they can keep a little bit of the styling from their existing bikes and move forward with a whole new class of bike. I think it'll work. So, did I miss anything? And if you watched this far and it's after February 22nd, let me know how I did in the comments below. You think Harley's gonna sell a bunch of these? I think they will. Anyway, until next time, keep the shiny side up.